गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल, माई सेल्फ बीती श्रीवास्तव फ्रॉम श्री शंकराचार्य महाविद्यालय डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स. टुडे माई टॉपिक इज मॉडुलस, देन इज पेपर ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट अलजेब्रा सेकेंड सेम मैथ्स. हियर आर कंटेंट्स, इंट्रोडक्शन, डेफिनेशन, टाइप्स, सब मॉडुलस, फाइनाइटली जनरेटेड मॉडुलस, साइक्लिक मॉडुलस, सिंपल मॉड्यूलो, सेमी सिंपल मॉड्यूलो, फ्री मॉड्यूलो, बेसिस, थ्योरम्स एंड एग्जांपल्स. डेफिनेशन ऑफ मॉड्यूलस, हियर आर इज अ रिंग, देन सबसेट एम ऑफ आर इज सेट टू बी लेफ्ट मॉड्यूलो इफ इट इज सेटिस्फाइड आर एम वन प्लस एम टू आर एम वन प्लस आर एम टू वेयर R belongs to ring and M1, M2 is belongs to M. Second point is R1 plus R2 dot M is equal to R1M plus R2M. R1 into R2 equal to R1 with braces R2 dot M. Next one is identity or unit element of ring. 1 dot M is equal to M for all M belongs to M. And another definition of modulus. And R be a ring, the subset M is said to be right modulo, satisfied the following properties. These are also is right modulo and above said left modulo. Similarly, then we see that M1 plus M2 and element of ring in right side. That's why it's called right modulo. And above equation R dot M1 plus M2, that's R is multiplied in left side, that's why it's called a left modulo. Here M1 plus M2 dot R equal to M1 R plus M2 R, M R1 plus R2 equal to M1 R1, sorry, M R1 plus M R2, M R1 R2, then change the brackets. Similarly, m dot 1 equal to m. Then types of modulus, here sub modulus, let m be the r modulus. Then n is said to be r sub modulus. It satisfied the two properties. A minus b belongs to n, where a comma b belongs to n. And r be the member of ring and a be the member of n. That implies r dot a is also belongs to n. Then n is called sub modulus of m. If M is an R modulus, then it is clear that 0 or simply 0 and M are sub R modulus called improper submodulus. Any other submodulus of M if exist is called a proper submodulus of M, finitely generated modulus. And R modulus N is called a finitely generated R modulus if M generated by some elements like x1, x2, xk, then M is called finitely generated modulus. Next is cyclic modulus. And R modulus M is called cyclic modulus if M generated by x, for some x belongs to M, that means x equal to R dot x, where R is a member of ring and x is equal to R dot x. Next is simple modulus. M has no proper subgroup, then M is called simple modulus. That means R dot M is not equal to 0 and the only R submodulus of M are 0 and M. Here R dot M is a submodulus of M, is the set of finite sum R1 Mi, where all Mi's belongs to capital M and R1 belongs to capital R. Here 1 belongs to ring, R dot M equal to 0 only if M of 0. Next, semi-simple modulo. And R modulus M is called the semi-simple if it is the direct sum of family of minimal submodulus. Next is free modulus. Throughout the section, unless otherwise state, we assume that R is a non-zero ring with unity, that is free modulus. Next is linearly dependent. Finite sequence x1, x2 up to xn, R modulus M is called linearly dependent. There exist scalar member A1, A2 up to An belongs to R not equal to 0, such that here is a linear combination A1 X1 up to An XN. That implies all A's is not equal to 0, that is called linearly dependent set. If all scalar are 0, that is called linearly independent set. Independence modulus. Next, here is a theorem. Define a simple modulo. Let R be the ring with unity, M be the R modulus, then prove following statements are equivalent. First, M is simple. Second, M is not equal to 0, and M is generated by any X belongs to M, and M is isomorphic to R by I, where I is a maximal left ideal of R. Here is a proof. First implies second. Let us take M is simple, then we have to show that M is not equal to 0 and M is generated by other element like X. Suppose M is a simple modulo, then M is a non-proper submodulus. Only 0 and M are submodulus of M. Consider element small x belongs to M. Then R dot x is not equal to 0 by definition of simple modulo. That implies x is a member of M. That implies R dot M is also not equal to 0. We consider a unit element 1 of ring, then 1 dot M is not equal to 0, then implies M is not equal to 0 again, since X belongs to M, such that R into X is a cyclic submodulus of N M. Either R dot X equal to 0 or R dot X equal to M, but R dot X not equal to 0 implies X generate M, implies M generated by X, hence second is proof. Second implies third. We show that M is isomorphic to R by I. Suppose M is not equal to 0 and M is generated by any X, then that implies M equal to R dot X, market equation 1. Let consider a maximal left ideal of R defined as I. R belongs to R, where R dot X equal to 0. Then we have to show that define a mapping. F is a mapping from R to R X defined as F of R equal to R dot X. Then we have to show that it is isomorphic. Then firstly we have show that F is a homomorphism. Property of homomorphism, we have to show that f of r1 plus r2 equal to f of r1 plus f of r2. Let us consider f of r1 equal to r1x, f of r2 equal to r2x. Then we take left hand side, f of r1 plus r2 equal to, as defined as a mapping, r1 plus r2 dot x, then r1x plus r2x, then that is f of r1 plus f of r2, thus f is homomorphism. We defined a kernel. By definition of kernel f, we know that it's contain element whose image is identity element or zero element, zero. Thus kernel f, R belongs to capital R, such that f of r equal to 0 or r dot x equal to 0. Thus fundamental theorem of homomorphism, we know that R by kernel f is isomorphic to R dot x. Here R by I, that means maximal left ideal I, that it means M is isomorphic to R by I, hence proved. Then third implies second. Suppose M is isomorphic to R by I, then I is a maximal left ideal of R, then U is a submodulus of R, then U by I is also submodulus of R by I containing I. I is a subset of U by I contains in U. Direct implies I subset of U, and then I is also a maximal left ideal of R. That means U equal to R. That means U by I equal to R by I. then RYI has a no proper submodulus that but RYI is isomorphic to M. Hence M has a no proper submodulus, M is a simple. This completes third implies first. Then next theorem. R, let R be a ring with unity, show that R is a modulo M cyclic if and only if M isomorphic to RYI for some left ideal I of R. Then let us see the proof. Let R be the ring with unity, I be the left ideal of R. Firstly, we have suppose that M is cyclic. Then by definition, we M equal to X, where M equal to R into X, mark it equation 1. And we define a mapping. F is a mapping from R to Rx by F of R equal to R dot X. Let's claim that F is homomorphism. Then we have to show that F of R1 plus R2 equal to F of R1 plus F of R2. Similar proof of above theorem shows that F of R1 plus R2 equal to F of R1 plus F of R2. F is homomorphism. Then again fundamental theorem, we put R by kernel F isomorphic to R dot X, where kernel F equal to maximum left ideal. We show in above theorem R by I is isomorphic to R X, equation mark number 3. Then we from first and second we get M is isomorphic to R by I. Conversely, suppose that M isomorphic to R by I, then from equation 3 we get R by I isomorphic to R X. Then conclude from equation 4 and 5 we get M isomorphic to R X implies M equal to R dot X. Hence M is cyclic. Then next theorem, F is a mapping from M to N, be an R modulus, then range of homomorphism F is N, R submodulus of N. Here is the proof. By definition of a range of homomorphism F denoted by image of F is given by IM F equal to F of X, where X belongs to M. To prove that image of F is submodulus of N, then we have to show that it is set on N range set. We have to show that it is submodulus. Let us consider a two arbitrary element of image M, F of X and F of Y. Then X, Y is also belongs to capital M. Now F of X minus F of Y equals to F of X minus Y, which is also belongs to image set of F. Thus F of X, F of Y belongs to image set of F implies F of X minus F of Y is also belongs to image of F. The first property proof, additive subgroup of N. Then second property, we show that R dot F of X equal to F of R dot X, also image of X. Then hence prove the property of second submodulus. Here image of F is also a submodulus of N. Here is an example. Example says that let G be any additive abelian group that G is a left Z modulo. Z means integer modulus. Prove that every abelian group G is a module over the ring of integer Z. Then we observe that G plus is abelian group, given that in example. There is defined a scalar multiplication, namely N belongs to Z, G belongs to G. Then we have N dot G also belongs to G, because N dot G equal to N times plus G. Then we get N, if for N is positive integer, if N is negative integer, we also have N dot G. N dot G1 plus G2 equal to NG1 plus NG2, N1 plus N2 dot G equal to N1G plus N2G, N1 N2G equal to N1 bracket N2G. For all integer N, N1, N2 is also belongs to Z, and for all G, G1, G2 also belongs to G, and 1 dot G is also belong equal to G, where G is belongs to G and 1 is the unit element of Z. Example 2, m is b and r modulus x belongs to m, then we prove that r dot x is an r modulus of m. Here, proof. Let solution is r1 x and r2 x be the member of r dot x implies r1 and r2 belongs to r, x belongs to m. Implies because m is modulus and r is ring, then we have r1 minus r2 also belongs to r. Then r1 minus r2 into x belongs to r dot x implies r1 x minus r2 x belongs to r dot x. Here r x is a subgroup, then we have to show that r1 r2 r1 belongs to r and r2 x belongs to r dot x. Then r1 r2 belongs to r, x belongs to m. Here similarly, r is a ring, m is a modulo, then r1 dot r2 belongs to r, x belongs to m implies r1 dot r2 in bracket multiplied by x belongs to rx. This implies r1 bracket in bracket r2 x is also belongs to x. Here r dot x in r modulus of r. Here is complete our solution. Thank you so much.